I just want to do God's will. And he's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over. And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
The good news for the black man is that he is on the verge of recapturing his position as ruler of the universe. The bad news for the white man is that his long and wicked reign will shortly be over.
The spirit of Esau and all his relatives of the Idumeans are the border of wickedness. Since the beginning of time, trying to establish his imperialism, all right, his dominion as a power structure over the world. Now this whole world lies in wickedness because of the influence, all right, of the wicked sea serpent. First off, I'd like to give all honor and glory to my heavenly Father, Yehovah Ba'ashim, Yehovah Shai, Ba'ashim, Raha Kodash, and double honors to the elders and apostles of the Great Millstone, who do the well, peace, and salutations to all you Akium in this truth. Shalom, all right, to all the lambs. This is the book of Deuteronomy 32 and 32. For their vine is of the vine of Sodom and of the fields of Gomorrah. Their grapes are grapes of gall. Their clusters are bitter. Their wine is the poison of dragons and the cruel venom of asp. Right? So that takes us to the book of Habakkuk, the second chapter. All right, because this man is a proud man. He rules by deception. The riches gotten by deceit, all right, are about to get vomited back up because the Lord is about to judge this place. All right, and the hand that rocks the cradle, which is this damn devil, Esau Edom. He's a madman. Habakkuk 2 and 5. Yeah, also because he transgresseth by wine. And what is his wine? All right, his philosophies, his false flags, his pseudoscience, his LBG, LBC, everything else that goes with that. If you can pick up what I'm putting down, right? His philosophies and doctrines. He's a proud man, neither keepeth at home. All right, who enlargeth the desire as hell and as death and cannot be satisfied. This is that man. And we're painting this picture through an illustration of this epistle of this man, of this wicked man. All right. He can never have enough. He's salacious. All right. He's lewd. He can never be satisfied. All right. But gather unto himself all nations and heapeth unto him all people. This is what's going on in the world. Right. So this is why this man is coming out of power. Because the Lord Yahweh Shai has had enough. His sins have reached the heavens because he controls everything with that wine. He has the ultimate influence over politicians, laws, governments, all right, militaries, synagogues. He's a thief. He's a robber. Stole the Lord's people, all right, the apple of the Lord's eyes, and put them on slave blocks. This is that thief. So as the Lord's people, how can we have anything to do with this man? We are a stranger in this land, right? And we have to go home. We have to get away from this monster. Psalms 137 and 3. There they carried us away captive, required us of a song, and them that wasted us required of us mirth, saying, sing to us one of the songs of Zion. And we're not able to sing the song of Zion in this land, right? We may have the song of Moses, all right? But we're not in the spirit of joy and of mirth until we get back home to our homeland, the land of milk and honey, right? Where the garden will be taken care of, all right, by the judges. So we're not singing songs of mirth, all right? But we are singing songs of salvation coming by Yahweh Shai. Through the scriptures, through the word going out, all right? Prophesying, all right? But we still have an enemy over our head. So we're in a strange land occupied by rulers of darkness. But he has sanctified the prophets to speak as the oracles of God. But Esau is attempting to silence the prophets by threatening arrest, all right, by hate speech. But we're not worried about nothing because the Lord said, remember what these people have done. All right, Psalms 137:7. Remember, O Lord, the children of Edom in the day of Jerusalem, who said, raise it, even to the foundation thereof. And that's what these Edomites done. And they're continuing to do this, right? By suppressing and oppressing the 12 tribes of Israel. When that whole COVID thing came out, they was only talking about giving it and prescribing it to the children of Israel. Because this devil wants to be all up in you, man, right? He wants to know everything about you. He wants to be your God. He wants to put his DNA in you by the form of an RFID microchip, where everything you do will be tracked. Everything you do with your woman or your husband, all right, in your romantic life, they're gonna know about it. They're gonna know your heartbeats, how many per minute, what you ate for dinner, breakfast, what you're spending your money on, right? He wants to be all up in you because he wants to be your God. This is why this devil and all his children must cease. All right, this is the book of Psalms 137:9. Happy shall he be that taketh and dasheth thy little ones against the stones. Now, why would the Lord usher such a punishment to a child? All right? Because you are the fathers of the past, colonizer, murderous devils who advocate death. All right, James 5:1. Go to now, ye rich man, weep and howl for your miseries that shall come upon you. Your riches are corrupted and your garments are moth-eaten, right? Your garments are moth-eaten and your riches are corrupted. All right, your gold and silver is cankered, and the rust of them shall be a witness against you, and shall eat your flesh as it were fire. You have heaped treasure together for the last days, right? And that's what you've done. You've gathered all the treasures, the oil, all right? The gold, the precious stones, the Lord's people, and you've heaped it all to yourself. And this is why NATO was going to turn on you, all right? Because you've put sanctions on all these different countries and you've stirred all this bullshit up, and the other nations aren't getting any shine. You're taking all the credit, America. So they're gonna turn on you, all right? The Lord's gonna lift up your skirt. That's what's gonna happen to Edom in these last days. James 5:5, you have lived in pleasure on the earth and have been wanton. You have nourished your hearts as in a day of slaughter. You have condemned and killed the just. You do not resist you, right? They can't resist themselves, right? They've lived in pleasure. They have the fatness of the earth, the dew of the heaven. Strong military, which is one of the unclean frogs, but they're spoiled. Esau is spoiled. His seed is spoiled, thus saith the Lord. Jeremiah 4:30. And thou art spoiled, what wilt thou do? Though thou clothest thyself with crimson, and crimson is that red color, all right? That dark red color, right? Which represents, in a sense, of Esau, Edom, red. Though thou deckest thee with the ornaments of gold, decking themselves with ornaments of gold, but it's fool's gold, because they're not the people who they say they are. They're imposters. So though thou deckest thee with ornaments of gold, though thou rentest thy face with painting, in vain shalt thou make thyself fair. Thy lovers will despise thee. They will seek thy life. That's right. They're going to seek your life. They're going to turn on you. They're going to turn on Esau, Edom, this bloody, deceitful, debaucherous man that he is. The Lord is about to bring it to your doorstep, Esau. All right? And he ain't knocking. Because these are the people who hate our God and push their own God. A God of lies, lust, okay? Adultery. Let's go to the book of Job 15. Showing you that this enemy is against Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai. Job had the spirit. All right, this is Job 15 and 25. For he stretches out his hand against God. All right, he stretches out his hand against God and strengthens himself against the Almighty. It says he's against God. So through the spirit, we're not preaching hate. We're warning you of these devils. He's the blue-eyed adversary in the flesh, all right? That same man, that so-called Malcolm X, a leader that y'all brothers follow, that y'all sisters follow so much, that said that he praises the same God as that so-called blue-eyed devil. The Lord said, all right, and those that pierced him, all right, those that pierced him, these modern-day Euro-Romans regenerated in the form of Babylonian Edomites. The Lord is coming back to judge. All right, so don't be deceived. This is 2 Thessalonians 2 and 3. Let no man deceive you by any means. For that day shall not come, except there come a falling away first, and the man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God or that is worshipped, so that he, as God, sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. Now, we read in the book of Job 15, all right, that he stretches out his hand against God and against the Almighty. So he's against Yahweh Shai, this devil, this man that you see on the screen. All right. Look at these examples that we're showing you. Okay. This dude is chasing a woman down a hallway with a chainsaw, man. This is the spirit of a devil. All right? Murderous scenes that I'm showing you. Why? Because this is the spirit. This is the fruit of him. Okay? So where's your so-called spiritual compass? Okay? To you Bible-thumping Christians who love to eat pork, swine, crab, and lobster. And says, oh, I don't judge anybody. Let the Lord do it. No, you judge and condemn through the spirit of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai so your brother and sister can stop the things that they're doing. You correct your own children, but not your brother and sister. That's hate. And this devil on the screen has taught you that. All right, so we're here to correct. All right, you need to pay attention because the time is sincerely running out, brothers. Okay, the time is running out. And brothers and sisters are being sealed every single day. So the enemy is moving fast because he has nothing but a moment to rule. And his time is almost fulfilled. The Lord said, wake up out that deep sleep. Okay? This is Isaiah 14 and 9. Hail from beneath is moved for thee to meet thee at thy coming. It stirreth up the dead for thee, even all the chief ones of the earth. It have raised up from their thrones all the kings of the nations. Thy pomp is brought down to the grave, and the noise of thy vows. The worm is spread under thee. The worms cover thee. This is speaking of the ending of this so-called white man. All right, being at a low state, squirming with the worms. You see, being low, back on his belly. All right, Job 15 and 31, let's get that. All right, this is Job 15 and 31. Let not him that is deceived trust in vanity, for vanity shall be his recompense. And that's all this man has pushed. that large cup of wine, all right, aged for perfection, all right, that has the whole world drunk.
And it's easier for a whole lot of people. If you're Muslim in this country, you don't have to worry if the president doesn't want you here. If you're an immigrant, you don't have to worry if the president's gonna be happier to have babies snatched away or send dreamers back for no reason.
Off vanity and deception, Job 15:34. For the congregation of hypocrites shall be desolate, and fire shall consume the tabernacles of bribery. They conceive mischief and bring forth vanity, and their belly prepareth deceit. All right? So their belly prepareth deceit. They practice wickedness. They lay snares and traps. They destroyed the Lord's gardens. What about the animals? Why do we have an endangered species? It's because of this bloody, deceitful man. Job 15 just told us, because he conceives in mischief, he brings forth vanity, and their belly prepareth deceit. So nothing clean can come from these witches and warlocks. All right? Listen to this.
That Joe Biden was underneath the Getty Museum in Los Angeles, California. I was there for a cock party. We walked through the museum, through the garden area, and employees led us to underground tunnels. People build these tunnels, and they've built them for decades. There's bodies of victims that are babies. There's people who run science experiments on babies. There's baby farms, elite celebrities. They go down there for parties. They have sick, satanic rituals.
So this is not a secret. All right, you heard what she said. All right, they got underground cities and bunkers. All right, they have life underground in the darkness, which is E's natural habitat. Their natural habitat is darkness. But we, all right, as the Lord's people, are children of the light. So we're going to speak against this naturally. This is 1 Thessalonians 5:5. Ye are the children of the light and the children of the day. We are not of night nor of darkness. So Esau, Edom are the children of the darkness. All right. They are the opposite of everything which is righteous that Yahweh Shai has brought forth. All right. They're that wicked root. They're that wicked branch. They're that evil brother. Let's go to the book of Revelation, the 6th chapter. All right. Because this is that red horse. This is Revelation 6:4. And there went out another horse that was red, and power was given to him that sat thereon to take peace from the earth. And they should kill one another, and there was given to him a great sword. Right, because there's power in the hand of the so-called white man right now. Biden has the power as the president, but who put him in the seat to be president? All right? So there's power, and there's absolute power, which the small hats possess. They're running all this shit. The Lord said we're going to have enmity with Amalek from generation upon generation. You see? Right? So Psalms 144:11. It says, rid me and deliver me from the hand of the strange children, whose mouth speak vanity, and their right hand as the right hand of falsehood. And that's what Esau is about. His right hand is falsehood. All right, the Lord says, set a wicked man over him, which is the devil, man, right? Sirach 40:12, speaking of bribery and injustice and falsehood, it says, all bribery and injustice shall be blotted out, but true dealing shall endure forever. And true dealing enduring forever is going to come by us being in rulership, all right? The heirs of the throne, all right? Who's going to occupy several parts of this world and be judges, all right? Run the earth correctly. true dealing shall endure forever. That's going to come by Yahweh Shai in the 144. And this is why it's a change right now in power. This is the book of Job 8:13. So are the paths of all that forget Yahweh Shim Yahweh Shai, and the hypocrites, hope shall perish. So hope shall perish for them. Matter of fact, let's get the next verse. It says, whose hope shall be cut off, and whose trust shall be as a spider web. We're painting a picture of this devil. This is Sirach 12:13. Who will pity a charmer that is bitten with a serpent, or any such as come as wild beasts? So these are the precepts that are painting this picture, like I said. All right, serpents, spider webs, wild beast, all right? Esau. In Revelation, the 13th chapter, tells you the number of this man, right? Everything is identifying with the scriptures and the clues of the mystery, which identify the man of sin, all right? Who ruled in this current beast system and who ruled in the Greco-Roman Empire, going all the way back to the Assyrians. And this current beast system ran by this damn devil, all right, is crumbling. And we're about to go into rulership. As the Lord said, he will stomp the winepress. We understand that the devastation must take place before the midnight hour, all right? Because that's when the Lord said he's going to come, when they're eating and drinking and being married, when they're not paying attention. This is Isaiah 13:9. Behold, the day of the Lord cometh, cruel, both with the wrath and fierce anger, to lay the land desolate, and he shall destroy the sinners thereof out of it. The Lord's coming for devastation and destruction. And he's coming for this serpent, man. Jeremiah 51:25, let's get that, all right? That destroying mountain. This is Jeremiah 51:25. Behold, I'm against thee, O destroying mountain, saith the Lord, which destroyest all the earth. I will stretch out my hand upon thee and roll thee down from the rocks and will make thee a burnt mountain. Let's get Isaiah, all right, 13, which is a beautiful chapter, speaking of punishing Esau, Edom, the things that they are going to go through and suffer, all right? The punishment that's going to come down on them. This is Isaiah 13:11. And I will punish the world for their evil and the wicked for their iniquity. And I will cause the arrogancy of the proud to cease. And they are arrogant people. This is the most proud, arrogant man the Lord has created besides Eve. And it says, and will lay low the haughtiness of the terrible. So the world is about to see what this thief is all about. All right. I hope this lesson has been edifying to the body and elect of Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, the lambs of Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone who do well. This the brother Azanamoth. On to the next Shalom.